Good afternoon. My name is Monica Cervantes. I actually come in and do the safety aspect. I talk about safety and environmental to the lease operators. It's an OSHA 10 general industry. I try to apply as much knowledge as I have. I've actually lease operated myself, and I've actually served as consultant in field. So I believe I bring a really nice perspective to enhance the OSHA 10.
So that's one part of your life. Can you tell us what you hold your background in and why safety is so important to you?
It's a personal goal. My father broke his neck in an oil field accident when I was 19. And my personal goal is to keep other employees from that happening to them. And I've reached beyond every limit I could see, I've reached. And I tried to find every certification out there, TEEGS. I went through the TEEGS program. I went to CSP. I'm actually on the board of Certified Safety Professionals and now serve on the board for the World Safety Organization. I'm the only female serving member on the board. I deal with ISO regulations. And here recently had a conference with a UN ambassador who actually awarded me the Environmental Safety Professional of the Year internationally. But all of those awards don't mean anything if somebody gets hurt. And so my goal is to keep people from getting hurt.
So you are our NJC Foundation alumni.
Yes.
Person of the Year.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, I have grown up, and literally grown up, in med school during college. I started out here when I was 18. I was a work study at Castor Activity. And at 19, I was teaching part-time faculty. Steve McCurley hired me as a part-time faculty. I taught aerobics, water aerobics, exercise ball, Pilates, you name it, I taught it. I did that for 17 years. It's been part of me and part of my family now. My son attends now, and I couldn't be more proud to have him come to New Mexico Junior College. I wouldn't have him go anywhere else.
So as a part of being an alumni person at New Mexico Junior College, can you tell us what your favorite memory is when you were attending?
Dr. Berner. He was an organic chemistry teacher, and he inspired me in his knowledge. He was a PhD, and he was so knowledgeable. And he never, ever allowed me to quit. And kept on me to keep going and pursue education. And that's what really helped me finish off my bachelor's and move on and go into my master's because of that. He just was a brilliant man and was just such a gem here. Yes, Dr. Berner.
What impact has New Mexico Junior College had on your life?
On every facet, it helped support me when I didn't have a means to support myself. Because the injury with my father was so devastating. I was 19, and it was very hard to pay the bills. And Steve McCurley gave me the opportunity to take on a part-time faculty position was unheard of. And I took that income and be able to pay the bills at home and excel in my career that I really, at 19, you don't realize it's a career, but it was. And being able to attend classes and brilliant, brilliant people that guided me, not just McCurley, Doc Morris, Kelly Holiday, John Baldwin, and Ms. Helms, they all helped shape the person I am today. I could run in there at any time, any point, and they weren't just people that taught me to learn in a subject matter. They taught me how to live life. I remember that I had one instructor in particular, and I had we as medical lab tech, and one instructor took me by the hand. I had just lost my brother and gave me the serenity prayer, and it meant everything.
If you could give advice to current and future students of New Mexico Junior College, what would you say to them?
Keep going. Don't stop. Don't listen to the naysayers. If it takes you 20 years to accomplish a degree, just do it. Don't stop.